The U.S. is distorting China's legitimate and lawful activities in disputed waters. That statement coming from Beijing's foreign ministry spokesperson Wang Wenbin. His remark came after Washington's defense chief Lloyd Austin reaffirmed America's commitment to its mutual defense treaty agreement with Manila following a reported increase in Chinese ships in the West Philippine Sea. Last week, the Philippine Armed Forces said more than 40 Chinese fishing vessels were seen swarming near the oil and gas-rich Recto Bank.
The United States' defense commitments to the Philippines must not jeopardize China's territorial sovereignty and maritime rights and interests in the South China Sea. The U.S.'s remarks misrepresent and discredit the legitimate and lawful maritime law enforcement activities of the Chinese side, driving a wedge between countries in the region. China firmly opposes it. The U.S. plot will never succeed.
That statement from the Chinese foreign ministry comes as Washington's Treasury Secretary wraps up a four-day trip to Beijing in a visit aimed at stabilizing rocky ties between the two world superpowers. Here's the full story.
A recent maneuver in the Taiwan Strait by a Chinese warship passing a U.S. Navy destroyer in what the United States called an unsafe manner highlighted the tensions between the world's largest superpowers. It was against this backdrop that U.S. Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen visited the Chinese capital late last week. In Beijing, she met with parties to discuss issues ranging from trade, the environment, and spying. There appears to have been some progress, but Yellen said the two countries still have a way to go.
The U.S. and China have significant disagreements. Those disagreements need to be communicated clearly and directly. But President Biden and I do not see the relationship between the U.S. and China through the frame of great power conflict. We believe that the world is big enough for both of our countries to thrive.
Yellen's trip follows the Chinese spy balloon incident from earlier this year, where a high-altitude balloon traveled much of the United States and Canada. The U.S. ultimately shot down the craft, and the Chinese government called that an excessive reaction. A topic of discussion brought up by new Chinese Vice Premier Hala Fong at a meeting last week with Yellen.
It is regretful that due to a series of unexpected incidents, such as the airship, the China-U.S. relations have had some difficulties, particularly in implementing the consensus of the two state leaders. We wish the U.S. side would take a rational and practical attitude, meet with the Chinese side halfway, and put positive remarks into actions so as to stabilize and improve China-U.S. relations.
Yellen also met to discuss what she called honest lines of communication, particularly around climate issues.
As the two largest economies in the world, it's in our interest to work together on these challenges, and it's something the world expects of us. And climate change is on the top of the list of global challenges, and the United States and China must work together to address this existential threat.
While a major diplomatic breakthrough wasn't expected by either country, Yellen's visit came amid a particularly turbulent time in relations. The Wall Street Journal reported last month that China had reached a secret deal with Cuba to establish an electronic eavesdropping station capable of gathering information from the southeastern United States. Further compounding issues recently was when U.S. President Joe Biden called Chinese President Xi Jinping a dictator. Arash Arabasadi, VOA News.
Well, another ally of the Philippines comes to the country's defense following its latest maritime encounter with China in the West Philippine Sea. Last week, Chinese vessels blocked and carried out dangerous maneuvers against ships of the Philippine Coast Guards conducting a resupply mission off Ayungan Shoal. China's move was criticized by the U.S. and Germany. And now France is joining the call for China to respect international law. It also urged Manila and Beijing to resolve the dispute without using threats or force. For an international studies expert, the two countries should come up with an amicable agreement, make that arrangement to prevent violent encounters.
If the situation continues like that, then that will really raise the risk of unintended violent encounters at sea. There's a need for the Philippines and China, especially their respective maritime forces, to really come out with an arrangement for coordinated patrols. The purpose of coordinated patrols to avoid accidents and prevent conflicts in this area.
Senator Aimee Marcos questioning the presence of U.S. military planes here in the Philippines. Marcos says on Friday, a U.S. Air Force C-17 plane landed in Manila and then later flew to Palawan. She adds another U.S. military plane from Tokyo was spotted in Palawan Saturday. Marcos says while she's aware of Manila's ongoing exercises with foreign militaries, the Philippine government must track any violations committed within its territory. She adds the same zeal in protecting the country's maritime interests must apply in the Philippine airspace. Senator Marcos calls on the military, defense, and foreign affairs officials to determine if these U.S. military flights affected ongoing tensions in the South China Sea. U.S. President Joe Biden now in Britain for the start of a three-nation tour. On the agenda, meetings with Prime Minister Rishi Sunak and a discussion on climate change with King Charles at the Windsor Castle. This will be his fifth meeting with Sunak in as many months. After his trip to the U.K., Biden will then head to Lithuania, where NATO leaders will gather for a key summit. Biden is then expected to travel to Helsinki for a meeting with Nordic leaders. Well, speaking of the NATO summit, Ukrainian President Vladimir Zelensky hopes for immediate resolution on various issues during the high-profile meeting this week. The alliance will tackle a wide range of topics in their two-day summit, including Ukraine's membership bid amid Russia's war and Sweden's access to boosting ammunition stockpiles.
We are working with our partners. We are working on security guarantees. We are also working on helping our partners to make some conclusions for this upcoming NATO summit meeting. And we would like to have all the decisions to be made during the summit. In this case, it's obvious that I'll be there and I'll be doing whatever I can in order to, so to speak, expedite that solution, to have an agreement with our partners.
Zelensky has called on the West to help its counteroffensive against Russia. The U.S. is set to provide cluster munitions to the country as part of a new $800 million military aid package. Over in Sudan, at least 22 people are killed and scores injured following an airstrike by Sudan's army in Omdurman City. The Sudanese army said special forces had killed 20 rebel soldiers and destroyed their weaponry. The fighting between the country's military factions is now on its 12th week. Thousands have been killed since the crisis started in April. Floods hit parts of Asia and the U.S. In southwestern Japan, at least one person is dead and three others are missing in landslides triggered by heavy rains. The state weather agency urged people to take shelter as it issued a special heavy rainfall warning for Fukuoka Prefecture. A landslide also hit central China. The tragedy left at least one dead. Search and rescue operations will continue for seven still missing. Torrential rains across the country have led to a number of deadly landslides. Now, over in New York, hours of thunderstorms in the lower Hudson River Valley inundated highways and homes. Local media said up to 30 centimeters of rain fell in the area just in a matter of hours. Police have closed roads and issued a rare flash flood emergency, urging residents to move to higher ground and avoid travel. America's climate envoy John Kerry says the climate crisis is reaching uncharted territory. He made that remark in an interview with BBC days after the hottest day on record was broken on three consecutive days last week. He now says the U.S. and China need to improve their relations and work together to address climate change.
China is a country, a huge country. It's the largest emitter in the world, and we need China to cooperate, and we need to cooperate with China. People are sort of in this standoff, but we can't afford to be, which is why President Biden has just had the Treasury Secretary in China talking about economics, but who also talked about climate. There will be other visits, and what we're trying to do is change the dynamic between our nations.